Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. My name is Lidya Kimeu from SOS Technical Training Institute, Buruburu. We are going to learn, or we have been learning about making the short. And today's lesson, we shall learn about making the double jetted pocket or the bound pocket. It goes by both names, either the double jetted pocket because of the jettings, which I shall show you, and or the bound pocket. Welcome. We will take the back piece, the two back short pieces. Having marked your pocket piece on the right hand side at the back of the short, then the first thing we shall do is make our dart, and that's what I shall do now. Stitch our dart, which is the shaping that we see at the back. Remember to reverse stitch at the beginning and also as you end. Start your stitching by reverse stitching at the beginning, and when you get to the end of the dart, you chain off. By chaining off, you continue stitching and then cut off your thread. And cut off the other end. Then you shall now iron. Always press your dart to the center back line. The fold of the dart should face the center back line. And we shall iron our interfacing on the wrong side of the dart. Let us go and iron. Remember, when you come to the iron box, to always set your temperature. And since we are working with heavy, medium weight fabric, we said we use the temperature of cotton or linen. If you're working with lightweight, use the temperature of wool or in between. Having set my temperature at 3, because this iron, that is where it is, I will now iron my dart with a fold line facing the center front. Iron your dart flat and ensure that the point comes out well at the end. Iron both pieces for the right and for the left. And remember, on the right hand piece for the back, we will be ironing our interfacing piece. This is our interfacing piece. The piece has two sides. There is one side that is shiny and another that is dull. Now, the side that is shiny has adhesive or glue on it. And this is the side that we shall place onto the wrong side of our back piece, and it should be centralized or in between the pocket mouth. The reason we have the interfacing on the pocket mouth is so that it strengthens or reinforces the pocket mouth to ensure when the pocket mouth is in use, it will not tear away from the garment. So place your shiny part on in between the pocket mouth. Having marked the pocket mouth, that's our pocket mouth clearly marked on the right side, but the interfacing goes on the wrong side. So place your piece back on the ironing board. Take your interfacing and centralize it on the pocket mouth and iron. Retain the temperature of the iron at what you have been using to iron. And as you iron, ensure that your piece lies flat. On the right side, it is also smooth, and there are no bubbles forming. Once you have finished ironing the interfacing, you can now go and work on the pocket mouth. Having ironed your interfacing onto the back piece, pick your jetting pieces or your jetting piece. We shall use one piece for today, and place it in the middle of your pocket. Draw your pocket mouth on, or transfer your pocket mouth on your jetting piece. Transfer using tailor's chalk, and then place your jetting and your back right hand side piece on the machine. Work a triangle, a rectangle, work a rectangle, with the line we had drawn being the center of the pocket mouth. Start by reverse stitching. Stitch gradually to the end of the pocket mouth. Pivot. Pivot once again to work the complete rectangle. To the other side of the pocket mouth. And reverse stitch. Remember, your pocket mouth should be even on both sides. Once you have wrapped the rectangle, you will need to cut the pocket mouth. Fold your piece and ensure that the stitching lines meet on the wrong side, like this, and cut along the center line. Open up, cut to 1 centimeter or half an inch of the end of the pocket mouth, and at that point, cut diagonally to the end, to the point. After cutting on all four corners, this is how the piece should look. Notice the triangles at each end, and then the center line. We have now cut the pocket mouth. This is what we are calling the pocket mouth. We shall now form the jettings. Turn your jetting piece to the wrong side of the pocket of the shot. You can finger press. The pocket mouth open. Press open fast. And then the seam allowances all face away from the pocket mouth, or face up or down. That's the top one. For the bottom one, finger press too. If you're not able to finger press, you can use the iron box. Notice the way I'm pressing. And the seam allowances should face away from the pocket mouth. These ones are the down ones, so they face down. And the top ones face up. Open up your pocket mouth to ensure it is open. That is the way the pocket mouth should look. Now, form your jettings by folding the jetting piece halfway. For the bottom one, it comes halfway the pocket mouth, and the top one too comes halfway the pocket mouth. Use a hand needle to hold the jettings in place from the right side, ensuring that the seam allowances all remain away or face away from the pocket mouth. Check that your jettings are equal in size. And then tuck the jettings together. If one jetting is bigger, reduce it and increase the other one. You can now go to the iron box and do the ironing. Remember when you're ironing to always check your temperature. Having formed the jettings, press them in place so that they do not move. Press them flat. Check that they are lying flat. There's no gaping or there's no opening. There's no space left. Then we now go and stitch. We shall stitch the seam allowances together with the jetting piece at the stitching line that we had done for the pocket mouth. We shall do the same for the other side. Let us go and stitch. Now we will stitch the seam allowances of the pocket mouth to the jetting at the line that we had stitched the pocket mouth. The exact same stitching line. Just start at the beginning, holding your jetting in place, ensuring that your jetting does not unfold, and stitch. Always remember to reverse stitch at the beginning and at the end and trim off your threads. Do the same for the underside. Lay your pocket mouth flat. Yeah, lay your pocket mouth flat. Then hold your jettings, your jetting and the seam allowances together and place them on the machine and stitch the two together. remember to go right over the previous stitching line. We have then held down our jetting pieces. Now we shall hold down the triangles. So ensure you pull them out completely. And do not stitch the pocket mouth, but just at the triangle point only. Do the same for the other side. Start off by laying it flat, pulling the triangle flat. Ensure that your jetting is also in place correctly. And stitch. Remember to also stitch right on top of the previous stitching line. Reinforce your stitching. And cut off your hanging threads. We have now formed our jettings. We will now attach our pocket bag. For us to attach our pocket bag, fold the top jetting and stitch it down. Stitch it down using the same stitching line we were using, but this time you will be closing the pocket mouth access from the top. And cut off your thread. And that's the way it should look. When you open your pocket, you will see the jetting piece and not the pocket bag piece. You can finger press as you wait to go and press your final press. Now, once you have formed the jettings and they are equal, then now attach your pocket bag piece to the jettings. Start with the lower piece. piece by placing the pocket bag right sides together to the jetting. Attach. Use a self-knitting seam, or you can overlock. I will overlock. Form your pocket bag. If your piece is too long, ensure that your pocket is 5 inches deep. And you realize that our pocket bag comes all the way to the top. This is because sometimes these pockets carry heavy things, and we need to support the pocket so that it does not tear our pocket mouth as we use it. Therefore, once you have attached the lower side, then attach the top side. Remember, there will be a piece hanging on top, because that is what will extend to the waist. Make your seam. And that is the way the seam should look. Cut off any hanging threads. Both on both sides. Then from there, now make the outside or the outer sides of the pocket bag. Work from the side where you see the triangles, which is like the wrong side. Stitch both ends together. I will stitch to that point and jump so that I'm able to overlock. Begin at the lower side and continue my stitching. And do the same for the other side. Always ensure that your pocket lies flat and stitch. I will also stitch to the seam so that I leave that seam allowance hanging free to enable me overlock. Turn the seam allowance and continue stitching. Cut off your thread. Cut off all threads. Always ensure that you have neat work and trim your threads as you work. We have now formed our pocket mouth, our pocket bag too, and we are now ready to overlock. Once you stitch the pocket bag, that's the way your pocket will look. Notice the piece hanging on top because we are going to attach it to the waist of the shirt. If I put my hand inside, realize that I actually have a bag that will hold my wallet or my items in place. Notice the rectangle. Notice the way the pocket mouth is. There are no pleats forming at the corners. It's all flat. We shall now overlock and then press our piece. We shall now overlock. Remember the piece, the seam allowance we were leaving hanging? That's the first one. We shall overlock. Right side up. Overlock and cut off your thread. Then now, hold your pocket bag right side up too. So the other end of the pocket shall be now on the inside. And overlock the edge. Ensure there are no pieces underneath. Remember, the overlock has a knife. Off your thread. Pick the other side and overlock. The seam allowance should lie flat and not this way. Ensure it lies facing the same side on both ends. Cut off the threads. And that is how our pocket should look when it has been overlocked. We shall now fold these pieces inside. and stitch it down from the machine. After overlocking, now hold the pocket to the pocket bag piece that went up, still on our stitching line. We do this to make sure that there isn't much strain on the pocket mouth as the wearer uses the pocket. Then now fold our pocket as I had shown you earlier to reduce the bulk at the waist or the extra material at the waistline of the short. Hold it down right at the waist. And cut off the extra material that is left up. And that is how our pocket looks. We can now give it a final press for it to lie completely flat. When you form your jettings, we should not see your pocket bag at the pocket mouth. Your jettings should always extend down so that we only see the piece that looks exactly the same. The jettings too should be cut from the same fabric as the main garment, but you can also use it as a design feature and use a contrast for the jettings. Let us go and iron. Iron your piece flat. Start off with the right side and proceed to the wrong side. The ironing we are doing as we work is referred to as under pressing. So any ironing you do as you assemble a garment is called under pressing. We have now formed our double jetted pocket. We have stitched it to the end. And this is how the pocket should look once it is finished. Realize that it lies flat. And now we shall attach the back to the front in the next lesson. Thank you, viewer. I have been your teacher, Lidya Kimeu, from SOS Technical Training Institute, Buruburu.